If the rebellion and Allied airstrikes weren't enough, Libyan dictator Muammar Gaddafi has been given another reminder why the tides might be running against him. His foreign minister has fled the country and is now busy spilling the beans to agents in London.
The decision by the former Libyan foreign minister to come to London to resign his position is a decision by someone right at the very top, and it tells a compelling story of the desperation and the fear right at the heart of the crumbling and rotten Gaddafi regime.
The pressure on Gaddafi is intense. The people around him are realizing that the days of this regime are numbered.
He was Gaddafi's right-hand man, a decades-long loyalist linked to assassination, torture, and international terrorism.
Clearly, Musakusa is a person with a lot of blood in his hands.
And now he's the regime's most high-profile defector, fleeing Libya on a private jet that took off from Tunisia and arrived in London, abandoning his rattled regime.
Mr. Musakusa asked the government for permission to rest because he is a very ill person.
In fact, he's now in a British safe house, with investigators slowly beginning to coax out years of electrifying secrets about Gaddafi's reign of terror.
Musakusa is not being offered any immunity from British or international justice.
Scotland Yard is one of the first lining up to question Kusa about the Lockerbie bombing. The FBI won't be far behind.
Musakusa was personally responsible for the actual organisation of it. The orders to do it clearly came from Muammar Gaddafi himself.
Kusa negotiated the release of convicted bomber Abdel Basset al-Megrahi in 2009, an investigation that remains open. On the streets of Libya, they call Kusa a traitor.
Down, down, Musakusa. Down, down, Obama. Down, down, Sarkozy.
But there's still a denial Gaddafi's ship is sinking.
People are saying, so what? You know, if someone wants to step down, that's their decision.
As rebels struggle and concede more ground, NATO has ruled it won't supply them with arms. America's backed away from that too.
There are many countries that can do that. That's not a unique capability for the United States, and as far as I'm concerned, somebody else should do that.
But there's fear that first, there should be a better understanding of exactly who Allied forces would be handing weapons to.
If we're going to start killing people on behalf of someone, I want to not get to know them better. I want to know who they are before the trigger's pulled. And that's the difficulty I'm having here.
Still a lot of difficult questions there. Emma Dallimore with that report.